next at 9, a new case of the coronavirus in the United States raising concerns.
So how bad is the coronavirus outbreak and how do you prepare? The World Health Organization says it has pandemic potential but has been steadily declining. Meanwhile, the mayor of San Francisco declaring a state of emergency in the city to prepare for a potential coronavirus outbreak. So should we be worried or not? So let's talk about it in practical terms so we can all feel a little bit better about our health in general. Dr. Sharon Thompson is joining us today with some precautions to take. And, you know, I assume, like all things, we shouldn't be overreacting.
We should not. So coronavirus is a family of virus that we know. Mm-hmm. These cause colds in this season of the year. And this one, though, is a new one. So we have to figure out the factors, the characteristics of this new virus. Mm-hmm. But we shouldn't panic. There are folks who are well-trained at the CDC and the WHO, the World Health Organization, who are taking care of this part of the outbreak.
Okay.
What you and I can do is our usual precautions.
Okay.
So I know lots of people are buying masks.
Yes.
And wiping everything down with Lysol and spraying. Mm-hmm. These things don't work against viruses.
Is that
the
true?
The things that do work and will help you is the things we talk about all the time. Good hand washing.
Okay.
Good hand hygiene. We spread viruses by touching our eyes and our nose and our mouths. And so if we wash our hands and keep those clean, we're less likely to transmit virus.
Adopt the protocol of a doctor, which is always wash in and wash out, right?
Wash in and wash out. Okay. That's fantastic. If you're coughing or sneezing, definitely use tissues or sneeze into your elbow or shoulder to avoid spreading droplets to people in your environment.
Okay.
And you might want to wear a mask if you are sick to prevent whatever you've got from spreading. But coronavirus is not widespread in the United States.
Right.
There have been about 53 confirmed cases. Most of those have traveled to the region of China that we're concerned about or close contacts of people who have traveled. Mm-hmm. It's only one with an unknown source and the experts are still working on that case. Mm-hmm. So most of us don't have anything to fear.
Yeah, it's funny because it's so unusual. It used to be so unusual to see somebody with one of these masks on, but now you're seeing, at least on social media, more and more images popping up of that. So in any case, would that be protective of something like this?
So if that person is ill, yes, it'll protect the rest of us from getting what they've got. Mm-hmm. If you don't have anything, then 9 times out of 10, we use the masks incorrectly. Mm-hmm. There's gaps between our nose and our mouths. We touch the mask frequently. We're constantly touching our eyes and nose, and then that's conferring no protection whatsoever. So most people who are using masks are not using them correctly, and they're not the right people to be using the mask. The person who's sick is the best one to put the mask on. Or the exception is if you're immunocompromised.
Yes.
So if for some reason you can't be vaccinated or you know that you have an immune condition, then you may want to wear a mask when you travel. And again, coronavirus isn't your biggest worry. It's all the other things that we all.
Right. And right now we are still in the middle of cold and flu season.
We are in the middle of cold and flu season. So get your vaccine if you haven't gotten it already. Mm-hmm. Because flu, there have already been over 15,000 deaths from flu in the United States.
Okay.
Versus coronavirus, zero deaths.
Yes. Yeah, that's incredible perspective because we really just get used to the term influenza and we don't worry about it quite as much, but it is pervasive. And if you are of any kind of compromised immune system too, or elderly,
if you have a chronic illness or elderly small children, we've had 2 deaths of babies in Arizona who couldn't be vaccinated. They were too young.
Mm-hmm.
So make sure that you get your flu vaccine to protect us against the virus that's far more common.
Okay. So this is antibacterial, antiviral.
Does work. Wash your hands.
But we're still okay to clean up.
Clean up, definitely.
Clean up all
you
like.
There are lots of other things that can make us sick.
Yes, we're not telling you not to clean up. Keep on cleaning.
Clean up. And airlines, thank you. Clean up.
Please. the most disturbing part of that whole thing was hearing that these are new protocols.
These are new.
Hey, we're vacuuming.
Yeah.
Hey,
I don't know
vacuuming.
How to feel about that.
Dr. Sharon Thompson, appreciate you so much. Central Phoenix Obstetrics and Gynecology.